In the PI Integrator, a view is a modeled description of the PI system data that you want to analyze. And there are three types of views. We have asset views, event views, and streaming views. In this video, we are going to focus on asset views, so views that allow you to organize your data around assets and then make some comparisons between your assets. We are going to create an asset view for our wind turbine metadata. So our wind turbines have several attributes that contain static values. In addition, each wind turbine also belongs to a specific wind farm. And this is the information that we will capture in the first asset view that we create. Let's get started. Let's begin by opening Google Chrome and navigating to the PI Integrator webpage by using the bookmark for PI Integrator for BA. Here we see the homepage where existing views can be managed or new views can be created. Four views already exist as solutions to this class. Now let's click the button in the top menu for Create Asset View and name the view Turbine Information. The view name becomes the name of the table or file in your target system. Depending on your target, you might be able to update it after a view is published. Great, so the first page that comes up in the view builder is where the search shape is defined. The search shape acts like a key and will return data from AF that match its structure. Click to create a new shape and then choose the server PySRV01 and database wind generation. To create a search shape, drag an asset, event, or attribute from the source asset section on the left into the search shape section in the middle. The matches section on the right will refresh to show how many matches were found in the selected database. For this shape, first drag the Big Buffalo Wind Farm asset into the middle section. Notice that one match has been found and it is the Big Buffalo Wind Farm. Next, let's expand the Big Buffalo Wind Farm asset on the Buffalo Wind Farm asset on the left pane and drag BB01 into the middle section. Notice that dropping the asset in different locations can have different behaviors. Use either drop as child or auto drop and place to have BB01 appear as a child of Big Buffalo Wind Farm. Right now, the shape is searching based on names. That means it is looking through the wind generation AF database and finding cases where there is an element named Big Buffalo Wind Farm that has a child element named BB01. To make the shape more powerful, we can use AF templates instead of element names. To do this, click the pencil icon next to the item in the search shape. First, let's click the pencil icon next to BB01. In the dialog that appears, let's uncheck asset name and check asset template. Choose the template wind turbine and click Save. Note that the shape now has 15 matches. It is now finding all the turbines within the Big Buffalo Wind Farm. Let's repeat this process to use the Wind Farm template instead of Big Buffalo Wind Farm. Now that the search shape is matching the needed assets, it is time to add the desired attributes to the shape. Just like with assets, these are dragged and dropped from the left pane. Once an asset is selected, its attributes will be displayed underneath. If there are many attributes, it can be helpful to group by category. For this example, let's drag the turbine specifications category onto the wind turbine in the shape. Just like with assets, these attributes are used in the filtering process. If an element doesn't have one of the attributes, then it will not be matched. Although we won't use it during this exercise, the attributes can be modified like the assets and can be marked as optional. If marked as optional, they will not be part of the matching criteria, which can be very useful when derived templates are used. Our shape is complete. Let's click on Next to continue to the Modify View page. Using the information from the search shape and its matches, this page governs how the data will be published. Additional columns can be added, existing columns can be modified, and data range can be specified. Since this view is publishing static data, let's set the sampling rate to 1 day by clicking Edit Value Mode and choosing 1 days and click on Save Changes. It's often best to use Interpolate with tag data. If exact is chosen, then all attributes must have a compressed value in the archive that exactly matches the timestamp, which is often not the case. You can notice that the timestamps do not have clean values. This is because the start time is now minus 8 hours. So let's set the start time to 1 minus 1 month and click Apply. Notice that the timestamps are now much neater. So let's click on Next to move to the Publish page. On this page, the target and schedule are set. The target configuration provides the list of pre-configured targets, such as specific databases, data lakes, or folders. If the PyView target is chosen, then users can access the data using the PyODBC driver. In this class, the SQL Server target will be used exclusively. So let's choose SQL Server from the drop-down list. For the run mode, choose to run on a schedule and have the view recur every 1 day. Doing this will ensure that any changes to the asset structure can be reflected in the published data. Let's click Publish to create the dataset. On the homepage, look for the new view turbine information. Its run status will update to publishing and then to scheduled once the data has been published. This concludes the video on creating an asset view for wind turbine metadata. To create this view, we first created a powerful search shape that takes the advantage of AF templates. We then modified the view before publishing it, and at the end, we publish it to the SQL server. Thanks for watching.